Music City, USA. It's Nashville Now.
Now, I would like to welcome one of my dear friends, and it's going to become apparent to you in a moment why she's here. She's here with a special mission tonight to talk about another television show. Would you please welcome Miss Barbara Mandrell?
All right.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Hello. Ralph, I appreciate so very much you're letting me come tonight and have the chance to talk to all of your Nashville Now viewers, because I am so, well, excited's not a big enough word. I am, I'm elated and thrilled about a show that will be on TNN tomorrow evening, and I think I just saw a promo for it as I was walking on, and it's probably uncomfortable for you to talk about it, because this is a show.
I'm going to let you talk about it, but I've never known you to be at a loss for words.
Well, not really. I talk a little bit, don't I, friends? Just a little, yes. My motor mouth.
I forgot my first song, so.
Well, you were the wonderful singer that you always are, and when you smile.
I made up my words, so.
Well, it worked, but you're a writer, so it works for you.
Well, thank the Lord.
Well, Farron, and thank you for the wonderful job you did on this show that'll be on tomorrow night. Everyone tells me, I was out front with you, Ralph, working and with the crowd, and I'm told that backstage that the atmosphere was just the best at the Opry House. The love, the camaraderie, the singing and good times. But we're very fortunate that there was a B-roll shot that night, so we have a little piece that was edited that I want to show to our friends.
Now, this was the night of the 7th of February.
Yes, and tomorrow night, the 7th of March, is when this show is going to air, and it's an all-star salute to Ralph Emery, and I'd very much like it if we could show some of that B-roll, and then I'll talk to you more about it.
All right. Let's take a look. What does it take to put on a great television special? Well, first it takes months of careful planning, people to design and build a beautiful set, producers, directors, technicians, a hard-working stage crew, lots of writing, and lots of cue cards, and of course, plenty of stars to read them all.
I tell you what I'd do. I'm going to be on a little while before then. I'll come back here and stay with you when I get finished, and we'll go out. I'll make sure somebody comes and gets you.
Then it takes hours of rehearsal as everyone starts putting together all of the pieces for that one big night. And, well, maybe time for a little fun. But whether it's work or play, you will still work up a big appetite. And there are always plenty of mouths to feed.
Contaminated. I've had three pieces. It's not that good. I want to take the rest of these to my dressing room, making sure that no one else is contaminated.
No one.
You know, TNN is never one to waste a moment. That's why here at the Lions backstage, where everyone feeds themselves between these huge productions, you see a lot of people just standing around and enjoying the company. That's why I'm all by myself here for TNN.
Now all you need is a star. But how do you put on a great television special without letting the star know who he is?
If you knew Ricky like I know Ricky.
Well, first of all, you call all of his friends, which happens to be just about everyone in country music. Next, you pass the word and invite all of the Stars fans to the Grand Ole Opry House for a spectacular star-studded evening of love, laughs, and songs. Of course, you need to pair up Barbara Mandrell with a great co-host. Then it's into makeup and hair, and though most of the guests don't need much help, an occasional one does, but hey, who's looking? Luckily, you don't have to look far to see a pretty face. Then be sure to give old friends a chance to just have some fun. But don't blink, because you don't know who's going to show up next backstage. And by now, you should be able to feel the excitement growing.
Here we are, folks, backstage. Picking and grinning.
We're picking greenly.
I'm picking on it. It don't make no noise.
Cause you're making plans to leave.
Now it feels like one big family reunion where superstars and future stars have all gotten together to surprise one of their dearest friends. Yet some people still may be a little confused.
What is this for?
Yeah.
That's right.
Well, hello. What? You don't want to hear what we've been talking about?
Yes, I just waiting here by the ladies' restroom, waiting for fabulous babes to come out.
Whoa, man.
That was on camera?
Yeah.
Are we in trouble now?
Let's do it again.
How you doing?
Do you think Ralph is onto it yet?
No, I don't think so. I don't think so, but I tell you what, it's driving me nuts because I'm following him around like a bird dog, and I'm going, and he started back toward the production office a minute ago, and I'm going, Ralph, just a minute, I got to talk to you about because we're going to dinner tomorrow night, you know, now what are we going to do? I got to meet you up there for dinner. It's driving me crazy. I'm so nervous.
You'll know soon.
Then, as the show begins, the unknowing man of the hour is about to find out what really brought all of these people together.
This is the all-star salute to country music.
Ralph, surprise.
That's right.
Well, Ralph, the reason why Johnny and I and all of these stars are here is because of you. The real name of this show is an all-star salute to Ralph Emery.
When it's all over, more than 70 stars have paid tribute to a man who has touched all of their lives. And afterwards, the celebration continues.
Good party.
Good show.
It's Pepsi, Mom.
All right. This is Dr. Ben Birdwell. This is Ralph Emery and my doctor. Personally, we needed him tonight.
Right. That's right. The reason I'm here.
Right. See that Mr. Emery don't pass out.
Only lots of great friends and the love of one very special lady could pull off such a great surprise.
Did everybody know about it?
Everyone but you, Ralph.
Everybody has asked me, I've been asked 200 times, were you surprised? Yes. How were they able to surprise you? Because this lady sent me down more phantom trails. I went to dummy rehearsals. I had a dummy script. She had me rewriting my dummy script.
And it really worked beautifully because you worked very diligently, very hard, dedicated.
I was trying to get my part.
Well, you wrote lovely things. We just didn't use them. There were many times, I want you to think back, do I have a couple of minutes
sure.
left here or not? There were many times I recall so many people, you know, we had an excess of 70 stars on this show to salute Ralph Emery, but there were so many, many that were not on the show that wanted to be there, that were booked elsewhere and no changes could be made. However, some that we were able to pre-tape a little, like the Statler brothers that love you so much, they were in Cookville performing, and we set it up, Jimmy Carter was a co-producer on this with Lynn Dorshek from out of Chicago, and Jimmy Carter arranged, when I told him he could go to Cookville and tape the Statlers, he got one of your friends from Channel 4 here to get the camera and go do it. Meanwhile, Harold calls, and he had to tell you, no, Ralph wanted to go to Cookville and do an interview for his radio show with the Statlers. And so Harold turned him down, you know what I mean? So,
you know what? What really hurt was after I had gone down to do the Hurricane Hugo show for them.
But they turned you down anyway, didn't they? It was great. And then another time, I was one of the three writers on this show, and so we would start every morning, usually by 9, but no later than 10 in the morning. We would work until about, I would say about 10 o'clock at night. Sometimes, I know there was one night, it went till about 3 in the morning, and this was for a month. And there was, during this time, I'm going crazy, so much work to do, and the phone rings, and it's Ralph Emery. He wants me to come and tape his radio show. I wanted to say, go jump in a lake. Don't you know I'm busy? But no, I did it. I went down and did your radio show and the whole time. And you were so nice to let me speak of this upcoming All-Star Salute to Country Music. And the last time I was on Nashville Now, I don't know if any of you will remember that we're watching, but try to think back. He kept pushing me unknowingly, but you kept pushing me. Things like, well, for example, that President Bush did a piece for it. How did you get President Bush? Why did he do it?
I said, what role does President Bush play in the All-Star Salute to Country Music? And you hemmed and hawed.
Oh, Ralph.
And you finally, you ignored me, and you started promoting the return of the Barbara Mandrell and Sisters show.
Yeah, now that starts the 31st of March.
Comes
yeah.
back to the network. And I didn't realize, I mean, you said I could ask questions.
Yes.
I didn't realize that Ken was assigned, Ken is her husband, of course, assigned to bird dog me backstage.
Oh, absolutely. In fact, friends, that day, and he was supposed to come in at his certain given time, it came over, we have like a little public address system backstage at the Opry, and it came over to say, Ralph Emery is in the building. Remember that? And then I recall that we got rid of you by telling you that we needed you to pre-record, whatever that's called.
Yeah, I do the opening for the show. I was the announcer.
Well, tell what we did to you.
Well, because several people were sick, notably, I think...
Jimmy Dickens.
Buck Owens.
And Buck Owens.
And anyway... They told me that we had to recut the opening. They couldn't edit those names out. So
right. This
is 20 minutes till 8 o'clock. Airtime is 8. They said, you've got to run over next door to the TNN building and recut the opening. I get over there. There's no tape. There's no script. And I've got this poor engineer calling all over the complex trying to get the tape and the script.
And
you
meanwhile,
let me stew for 10 minutes.
But the reason for that... See, the reason for that was I wanted to speak to our audience, and I wanted them, because they were the big part of the surprise, too. So I wanted to tell them what was going on. And our viewers at home, as you watch tomorrow night, you're going to be such a part of this. I know Ralph can say nothing of this nature, but I've never felt, never, that kind of love and the emotion. Everything was so thick you could cut it with a knife. It was marvelous. I also appreciated you showed me a review we got in People magazine for that show a few minutes ago before we went on the air. What did they say I did?
Said you slathered all over me.
I slathered all
I
over Ralph
it.
Emery. Whatever that means, I
loved
slathered.
It.
But we got a B
plus
rating in the People. I'm telling you, it's an A-plus show, and I'm so very proud that all of our friends did it.
It'll be on tomorrow night.
The All-Star Salute to Ralph Emery airs tomorrow night on TNN at 8 o'clock Central. And it is also a beautiful way that we're able to celebrate and to salute. And aren't we lucky to have TNN?
Yep.
7 years.
Absolutely.
Fabulous.
And I owe a great debt to you and to TNN. I owe thanks to TNN for the ride I've been able to take here for 7 years. But Barbara Mandrell Productions produced this show, and I thank you and Ken and all the people that worked so hard.
Well, it was a piece of cake getting all these giant stars there for you. All I had to do was say your name, and Farron and everybody else said, I'll be there. And I appreciate so much you letting me tell all your viewers about this. Don't miss this show. It's wonderful. And our great thanks to you, Ralph.
Barbara,
we love you so.
Thank you.
I'm going to slither you again.
Right. Slather.
Slather.
All right. Slather me one time.
Oh.
All right. Let's say good night to Miss Barbara Mandrell. Oh, she's wonderful.
Isn't that beautiful?
Beautiful, yeah. I need to take this break here, and then I'll say something else.
The Nashville Network.
I can't talk very loud because I'm going to tell you something that not all of the performers on tonight's show know. Well, there's only one person who doesn't know, Ralph Emery. We've planned something very special to happen to him tonight, and you're going to be a part of it. So don't you dare go anywhere, because we are all going to give Ralph the surprise of his life.
Tonight, from the stage of the Grand Ole Opry House in Nashville, Tennessee, the Nashville Network presents the All-Star Salute to Country Music. With host Johnny Cash and Barbara Mandrell. With Ralph Emery, Alabama. Tom T. Hall, Willie Nelson, Randy Travis, Marie Osmond, Roger Miller, Grace Stevens, Roy Clark, Kathy Matea, Baron Young, Reba McIntyre, Jimmy Dean, Ann Murray, Jeannie C. Riley, Barbara Fairchild, Jeannie Pruitt, Lynn Anderson, Jeannie Seeley, Kitty Wells, Patty Lovelace, Connie Smith, Larry Gatlin and the Gatlin Brothers, Shotgun Red, the Oak Ridge Boys, Merle Haggard, Ricky Skaggs, the Whites, Glenn Campbell, Grandpa Jones, Chet Atkins, Jerry Reed, Steve Warner, Lee Greenwood, Earlene Mandrell, Hank Williams Jr., June Carter Cash, the Statlers, Tanya Tucker, Williams and Reed, Tennessee Ernie Ford, Ronnie Robbins, John Ritter, Shelley West, Marty Haggard, Lori Morgan, Dolly Parton, Kenny Rogers, Ricky Van Shelton, T. Graham Brown, Charlie Daniels, Bill Anderson, Waylon Jennings, Minnie Pearl, Porter Wagoner, Eddie Arnold, the Forrester Sisters, Susie Bogus, Crystal Gale, Roy Acuff, Holly Dunn, Dobie Gray, K.T. Oslin, the Jerry Whitehurst Band, and a special appearance by President George Bush.
Hello, I'm Johnny Cash. I've always been known as a man in black, singing about the man that's fighting back. Just like him, I'm down sometimes, so I found the music and I start to shine. The longing tears and the hope and joy, a 3-minute song about a girl and boy. The secret of living out a happy life is a song in your soul and love inside gives rhythm. When you get the blues, come on, get rhythm. When you get the blues, if you put a beat to a real sad song, you'll find you won't be sad too long. Get rhythm when you get the blues.
Hello, I'm Barbara Mandrell. Well, I've always been a man in a tie. Music's a big part of our life. Tonight we'll put a smile in your heart, cause the biggest family of all takes part. You don't have to pick or sing along. If you love this music, then you belong. Get happy and clap and stomp your feet, cause the fans are the reason for the family tree.
When you get the blues, come on, get rhythm. When you get the blues, if you put a beat to a real sad song, you'll find you won't be sad too long. Get rhythm. When you get the blues, hey, get rhythm. When you get the
From the songwriter to the record buyer and all the people in between, the love we all share for country music unites us as a great big family. And tonight is a celebration of the music and the people we love. It also marks the wonderful night 7 years ago when the Nashville Network was born into our family. That single event has made it possible for us to have a family reunion every day of the year. This is the All-Star Salute to Country Music. And here hosting together for the first time are Mr. Johnny Cash and Miss Barbara Mandrell.
Thanks, Ralph. And don't go away so fast, all right? Ladies and gentlemen, this is Ralph Emery. And you'll have to forgive him. You'll have to forgive him because he's got things a little bit mixed up. This is not an all-star salute to country music.
The reason why Ralph has such a surprised expression on his face is that he really doesn't know what's going on here. Well, Ralph, reason why Johnny and I and all of these stars are here is because of you.
You're kidding.
The real name of this show is an all-star salute to Ralph Emery.
Tonight, we want to show you who the real Ralph Emery is. And all the way, and all of us in the country music industry love Ralph so much. Just watch this. Turn around and watch this. Ralph Emery is one of country music's best-kept secrets. There is probably no man in America who has affected country music more.
I first met Ralph when I was back in high school, and my sister Loretta took me to his all-night radio program. And I was so in awe and so nervous that when Ralph asked me a question, all I could do was nod my head. It didn't take long for Ralph to tell me you had to speak because they can't see you on radio.
15 years ago, he began hosting an all-night radio show on Nashville's famous WSM. And from there, he went on to entertain millions with his national radio and TV shows.
Good morning and welcome to our show. Tuesday, March the 8th, 1966. We're happy to have you here.
He's well known to those of us in country music, but he's never really received the credit and the recognition that he rightly deserves.
Who is this man who occupies such an important place in country music history? What has he done to bring about the respect of so many?
Why do the biggest stars in country music seek out his advice and counsel? We love Ralph very much, and by the time this evening is over, we hope you will too.
Tonight, we want to show you and tell you the enormous impact Ralph has had on the lives and on the work of those of us in country music.
There's probably no one in America who's been involved with more country music stars than you have, Ralph. You put them on television, you've spun them on your radio turntable. Now it's our turn to put you here on our turntable tonight and spin you around.
Ralph, I don't know how we're gonna pack everything and everybody who wants to have a part into these 2 hours, but you just sit there and you watch as we all sing your praises tonight.
Everybody, like Grandma and Grandpa used to play. Then I'll float on down the river to a Cajun hideaway. Drift away like Tom Sawyer, ride around with old Huck Finn. Take a nap, well, well, like Rip Van Winkle. May he dream.
Your eye on old Ralph tonight and expect the unexpected. When the group of stars that this show has gets together, history is going to be made. So don't you miss a minute of it.
Daryl Royal? I don't know. There's a lot of names on there of people that I don't even know.
How do you qualify to sign the guitar?
You just got
to
have a pencil.
Oh, I see.
Ralph said to one new young singer before he sang on his morning show, he said, "Boy, are you any good?" And he said, "Well, some good." But once he heard this young man, Ralph had him on his show many, many times.
Are you comfortable tonight? Having a good time?
I'm having a good time.
Okay, why is that mic shaking?
that's a good question. A little nervous, I think.
Randy, don't be nervous. You're among friends.
Ladies and gentlemen, Randy Travis.
Is he cute or what? You know, a lot of friends wanted to be here tonight of yours, and they couldn't. One of them especially couldn't be here tonight, and he asked if I could read this telegram to you. So I'm a very dear friend of both of ours. It says, "Ralph, I would have been here in person, but I have a show to do in California. Those of us who don't have talk shows, you know, have to work for a living. I know everybody in Nashville is there with you tonight. Why don't you just give out the Country Music Awards tonight and save everybody a trip? Congratulations, Ralph, and I wish you the best. You're one gentleman who has never let success go to your golf game. Best wishes, Bob Hope."
Right now at Sears.
California to get behind TNN. It's down home.
There's nothing like hearing a great new lyric for the first time. That's why I like Owen's Days. A great little show.
Imagine your very own television network, TNN.
Man, if you love country the way I do, then do what I do. Pass the word about TNN.
It's quite an honor, and I don't know how to feel about it. So I just don't feel. Except happy. So to be safe.
You cried the other day, didn't you?
That's none of your business.
Ralph, I know this evening is probably as much as of a surprise to you as it is to me. Actually, I thought this was a benefit for the homely.
The beauty of live television is whatever happens, happens. Ralph Emery does 3 hours of live television every day. So he gives us all the opportunity to share some very strange happenings.
We searched for the right reason to do a musical expression of a performer's innermost feelings of Ralph and found Ray Stevens. Well, normally he's out on the golf course with Ralph. In fact, Ralph calls him the Jack Benny of golf because even if there's a dollar riding on the game, he takes 3 minutes lining up the shot.
Here with a special composition just for you, Ralph, is your tightwad buddy, Ray Stevens.
This song is for you, Ralph.
Been a friend to me and to all of us in the industry. We love to do your show and we're thrilled when you call. Yeah, we love you like a brother, but at one time or another, Ralph, you have embarrassed us all. Yes, you have. You have embarrassed us all. Watch this.
Go back a ways, back to those black and white television days when I'd do your morning show and I'd be there early standing tall. Now I've got a clip of two young guys there with a lot less gray in their hair and an incident I bet you will recall. Now look at this.
Hello, Ev. You make movies a lot. You have an excuse because you're tired.
You're just punchy all the time.
I wouldn't say that.
Oh, what would you say?
I'd say that the ducks are flying low this season.
Yes, we love you like a brother, but at one time or another, Ralph, you have embarrassed us all.
Yes, you have.
Yes, you have.
You have embarrassed us all.
I say, ladies and gentlemen, Miss Kathy Mattea.
It's not always things you say that makes our faces red. Why, heaven knows, Ralph, I've done your shows and can't believe the things I've said.
Is there Mr. Wright in your life?
Well, I don't know. I have many friends.
I sure hope so, because you're going to put him to work, and I hope he likes you a lot.
Yeah, I choose a man by the kind of tools he has, Ralph.
Thing I've seen happens every Halloween when you dress us up in costumes, one and all. Yeah, you turn us into witches and freaks, ghosts and goblins, germs and geeks. Well, once I was a convict with just a chain and a ball.
You used to be a sheriff, didn't you?
I used to be a sheriff till I got a divorce, and this is all she left me.
You mean that little ball there is all you got left?
One ball, pal, one ball.
Ralph, you've been a friend to all of us, and it's not our aim to complain or fuss, because we'll be here whenever you should call. Yes, we love you like a brother, but at one time or another, Ralph, you have embarrassed us all.
Yes, you have.
You have embarrassed us all.
Yeah.
one person planning on being here tonight. In fact, she was looking forward to it so very much. But because of the baby, she has to take it easy.
And we told her not to even try to come tonight, and we should bring the camera to her. Here is a dear friend and an incredibly talented lady.
Please. Hello, Reba.
Hi, Barbara. Hi, Johnny. Hi, Ralph.
We are so excited about the baby.
Oh, thanks. We're thrilled, too. You know, I think there's only one person that could take me away from the baby at this time. Of course, Robert Redford couldn't be here tonight. So, Ralph, you're second place, old bud. But, you know, don't take that as an insult. You know, it's pretty good company with Robert Redford. But anybody who has ever seen Ralph Emery in person or on the television or through the radio can kind of relate to what I'm talking about. Ralph, this is your great points. You know, you're really good at keeping a secret. Like when someone is on the show with you and at a commercial break, you say, you want to do a song? And you say, well, no, I'm not really prepared. And then right when the camera hits you, Ralph says, Reba, how about doing Can't Even Get the Blues Tonight? And you're like, I'm going to kill you. I really am. You're really good at that. And all I really like, the other points that you're really good about is when you really get into a deep story and you're really doing good, you ask another question. That's always another good point about you. You're really a sweetheart. But Ralph, honestly, from the bottom of my heart, I love you. You've been a great inspiration. And I'm proud to be your friend. Congratulations on a great night. You got lots of friends, buddy. You're pretty good.
Reba's right. You do have a lot of friends, Ralph.
And country music's most important friend has some things to say to us in just a moment.
Stay tuned for more of the All-Star Salute to Ralph Emery.
We tried reversing the roles with Alex Trebek, the host of Jeopardy.
An old friend, when Barbara called me and told me about this, I wanted to be there so badly. I tried to cancel some things. I did not get them done. I was committed to do them a long time ago because I truly wanted to be there, maybe pick on you a little bit. But I wish everyone could know you as I know you. And I can say honestly, I mean it when I am proud to say that Ralph Emery is my friend. There's another fella that wanted to add a little something to this night of accolades, or whatever you'd like to call it. He's a friend of yours, a friend of mine, and a great friend of country music. What can I say? Mr. President?
Thank you, Jimmy. Ralph, you've certainly been with us through some of country music's most memorable moments. Your radio and TV shows have spread the word about our beloved country music to millions. And they also have been important steps on the road to success for many of the stars. So, Ralph, on behalf of Barbara and me, thank you. And thanks to everyone in country music for making such a great contribution to American life. Thank you. Have a great evening. And God bless you all.
Barbara, you know, I could never figure out why, but all the ladies in country music seem to love Ralph Emery.
Oh, yes, we sure do.
Ralph, here's another one of those who loves you, one of those great ladies, someone that you always refer to as Canada's national treasure, Anne Murray.
Daughter who attended Harper Valley Junior High.
band stopped to play. And she said, Mom, I got a note here from the Harper Valley PTA. No, I wouldn't put you on because it really did. It happened just this way. The day my mama socked it to the Harper Valley PTA.
Barbara Fairchild.
I was a teddy bear, not living or loving, nor going nowhere. I wish I was a teddy bear, and I'm wishing that I hadn't fallen in love.
Lovelace.
Grapefruit juice like
in California is in a bank in the middle of Beverly Hills in somebody else's name. So if you're dreaming
brothers. What great harmony, huh? Yeah. But if they only knew the power of the voice, and to think that he has remained tight-lipped through all of these years. For Ralph to use the microphone to simply talk into is just not fair. The ears of America are being deprived of such great hits as...
In the misty moonlight, by the flickering firelight.
Hey, you know, I spent my life collecting the 6 or 7 records that are still in circulation. The hardest, of course, to find was Ralph's Liberty Records smash hit, Hello Fool.
Hello Fool. Look around. Where are the walls?
Through years of listening to Ralph's voice, I have come to the conclusion that there's only one voice that could blend with Ralph's. Mine. Anyway, that great blend has earned us 2 albums on RCA Records. And you know what, folks? Rumor has it that this next group has secretly purchased the album and studied the Ralph and Red version of Elvira. Can you believe that? And they're getting ready to attempt it right now. Good luck, guys. Ladies and gentlemen, the Oak Ridge Boys.
Like cherry wine, but that
when my mother passed away, she'd been a dyed-in-the-wool Christian all of her life, and I felt that preachers were something that wouldn't really be needed at her funeral. So instead, I asked Ralph Emery to come out and read her life story that she'd written on herself in freehand. And he did that for me. I think he's a great host, and sometimes he gets people in a corner on purpose, but he's one of my greatest true friends, I think, in this business.
Ralph has always been a big fan of gospel music, and no one does gospel music any better than Ricky Skaggs and the Whites.
You trust your family doctor and a druggist for your pills. You take them every day and believe they'll cure your ills. And you want a lawyer present when a business deal goes down. But you're scared to death the preacher's talking hell or heaven bound. If you don't believe, God's holy Bible,
God's holy Bible,
and your faith,
and your faith's not in the Lord,
then you can't get to heaven to receive your just reward.
If you don't believe,
if you don't believe,
if you don't believe,
if you don't believe, if you don't believe the Bible, then you don't know the Lord. When you get on an airplane and the ground cannot be seen, you have to put your faith in the man in his machine. Yet you shy away from preachers and you don't believe in prayer. Just because you can't see Jesus doesn't mean he isn't there. If you don't believe,
if you don't believe
God's holy Bible,
God's holy Bible,
and your faith,
and your faith's not in the Lord,
then you can't get to heaven to receive your just reward.
If you don't believe,
if you don't believe,
if you don't believe,
if you don't believe, if you don't believe the Bible, then you don't know the Lord.
If you don't believe,
if you don't believe,
if you don't believe,
if you don't believe, if you don't believe the Bible, then you don't know the Lord.
Back in the late 60s, there was a young guy on Ralph's early morning show who he predicted would become a great star. Well, whoa. Boy, Ralph, you sure can pick him. Ladies and gentlemen, Glenn Campbell.
I am a lineman for the county. he's still on the line. Got a Wichita lady on his mind.
Thank you. Great crowd. God bless you.
Good evening. I'm Chet Atkins. You know, Ralph Emery and I have heard just about everything and everyone that's made a noise in Music City over the years. I guarantee nobody's ever seen this act before. Probably because it would be too expensive to get them all to sign a contract, don't you know? But then Ralph always was good at getting us to do different and new things. Here for the first and last appearance, the world's most famous unknown band. Here we are.
Ralph, this is Bo Cephas. You know, you're a lot like me. You've been around forever and haven't received much recognition until lately. But with me, you've been number one in my book for a long time, from the times I used to visit you and Tex Ritter on the late night talk shows at WSM Radio. And thank you and all the respect in the world to you and everything you've done for country music. From Bo Cephas, I want to give you an all-star salute, sir.
Thanks, Bo Cephas. You've already met my co-host tonight, but here he is to sing with one of the most brilliant, funny, entertaining, and classy ladies I know, June Carter Cash.
If I was a carpenter and you were a lady, would you marry me anyway? Would you have my baby?
You were a carpenter and I were a lady, I'd marry you anyway, I'd have your baby.
If I was a miller and a mill wheel grinding, would you miss your sparkling dress and your soft shoes shine?
Shining.
Save your life through loneliness, save your life through sorrow, gave you my onlyness, give me your tomorrow.
Ralph a quail hunting not too long ago, and we got up three or four coveys of quail, and Ralph, when they'd fly up, Ralph just would point his gun at them and not shoot. And I said, Ralph, why don't you shoot? And he said, well, every time I get sight on one, another gets in the way.
The Statlers have done something very, very special just for this show. So here they are, Harold, Don, Phil, and Jimmy, the Statlers.
We tried hard to write a song.
Ralph.
We worked hard and we worked long.
Ralph.
We'll tell the world without a fuss.
Ralph.
All the things you've done for us.
Ralph.
There was a time that you, let me see.
Ralph.
Okay, let me see. Now, one time you, resisted.
Ralph.
I'll be able to think of something that you've done.
Ralph.
Ralph who?
Ralph.
Excuse me? Ralph Emerson? Anybody know him? We don't have anything on under these robes.
Did he actually write that song, the whole thing?
Yes, they wrote that just for him, for this show. And did you know, John, that I have something in common with our next guest? We were both in grade school when we started our country music careers.
Ladies and gentlemen, here is Tanya Tucker.
Delta Dawn, what's that flower you have on? Could it be a faded rose from days gone by? And did I hear you say he was meeting you here today? To take you to his mansion in the sky. She's 41, but her daddy still calls her baby. All the folks round Brownsville say she's crazy. All she wants to take you to his mansion.
pretty much how it happened.
You know, if you ever had an enema, you wouldn't weigh 15 pounds.
What?
That's pretty good.
Somebody write this down. 6 years he's been on the air, and he finally made a funny, okay?
Yes, right. And a darn good one.
And a darn good one.
Here they are, Williams and Reed.
I'm the white guy.
And I'm the Indian. And we're proud to present our own personal journey down Emory Lane entitled...
A two-minute tribute or Ralph in a nutshell. To examine the career of Ralph Waldo Emery, we must first start at the beginning and explore the many stages and phases of his long but exemplary existence.
Born on the telephone in the 30s, Ralph had not yet begun to take carve a career or his hair by the time he was 19.
By age 20, his calling had come.
Country music became his quest and his quarry. As he racked up
a Kool-Aid after a Kool-Aid,
accolade
after accolade for his diligent work on WSM radio.
As his radio personality gained momentum, so did his penchant to adopt the manner and look of other stars he admired.
Here we see him in his Jim Neighbors period.
Mm-hmm. And here we see him in his Wolfman Jack period with rock puzzier David Byrne of Talking Heads. But
he's still the cat silk lounging jacket to us
and the world.
Thanks,
this
Ralph.
This has been a portion of Williams and Reed's mini documentary, Emery, the Man and the Air Freight, to be seen at a later date.
One legendary DJ a long time ago made popular this phrase. This record is stronger than a garlic milkshake.
Oh, I know that. I know that. In fact, he quotes him all the time. I know who that is. That's the legendary Tennessee Ernie Ford.
He was born one morning in McEwen, Tennessee. And there he sits for all the world to see. If it weren't for Ralph, where would we all be? Knocking on doors in Printer's Alley. He fills the studio with lots of folks, then brings on stars with music and jokes. So if it wasn't for us, where would Ralphie be? Singing Hello Foos. That was a good record, Ralph. Back on Liberty. We love you, Ralph.
Ladies and gentlemen, Johnny Cash.
I hear a train a coming, it's rolling around a bit. I ain't seen the sunshine, so I don't know when. I'm stuck in Folsom Prison, and time keeps dragging on. But the train keeps a rolling on down to San Antonio. When I was just a baby, my mama told me, son, always be a good boy, don't ever play with guns. But I shot a man in Reno just to watch him die. When I hear that whistle blowing, I hang my head and cry. From this prison, if that railroad train was mine, then I'd move it on. that's where I want to stay. And I'd let that lonesome whistle blow my blues away.
Johnny Cash is so wonderful. You know, not only is he wonderful, oh, he's sure married so fine. I love this lady so very much. And since I am very proud of being a woman, I ask Ralph, you know how I feel about this, I ask if June would join us. So this part of the show, I now have a female partner, and we are your guards up here. The family tradition is such an important part of country music, and John and June are a fine example of that. And one of the things that pleases me the most is to be able to watch the children of country music legends establish their own careers and still maintain a deep respect for their parents, their famous parents. And nowhere will you see it stronger than in the children of the five people that happen to be five of Ralph's closest friends over the years. Tex Ritter, Dottie West, Merle Haggard, George Morgan, and Marty Robbins.
Do not forsake me, oh my darling, on this our wedding day.
Woodward Maurice Ritter. You know him as just plain Tex. He called me Jonathan. I'm really proud of the way the bronze plaque at the Country Music Hall of Fame describes him. One of America's most illustrious stars of radio, TV, records, movies, and the Broadway stage. His devotion to God, his family, and his country is a continuing inspiration to his countless friends throughout the world. Well, my dad was very special. He was very lucky, a big star, but very gracious. He was always very proud that he was one of the first cowboys to kiss the girl at the end of a cowboy movie. He said that after 2 hours of fighting and shooting, by God, I deserve it. And that was actually before he met my mom on a movie set. And from then on, she became his leading lady both on and off the set. And why we're here tonight is to salute Ralph Emery. There were a lot of stories, Dad and Ralph Emery. That studio at WSM was his and Ralph's home away from home. He loved hosting that show with Ralph. More than once, even when he traveled, he'd stop off to see Ralph before he got home to see Mom. And something kind of special happened during those times. Dad would go in tired and dragging from a tour and come out ready to take on the world. Mom would bring them cookies at the radio stations as they sat and talked through the night. And people said that Dad and Ralph were like two big kids watching for and waiting for their treats. He was one of the wisest men I ever knew and one of the funniest. He traveled the nation and the world making friends and gaining a depth of knowledge and understanding that few others possess. He treated Ralph actually much like he did my brother and me, always giving advice even when we didn't want it, and telling stories that were intended to teach us something. I wish he were here to tell us some of those stories tonight, but then in a way I guess he'll always be with us, and we'll always be with him. Ralph Emery, on behalf of my brother, my mother, and my father, we salute you. I'm Shelley West, and that's my mom. I think I was five when that record came out and became a big hit. And it was really the first time that I began to see the impact that Dottie West, the entertainer, had on people. Anybody that knows my mom knows that she's a hard worker. But what some people don't know is that from a little farm in McMinnville, Tennessee, it must have seemed like a million miles to the footlights of the Opry. She always looked on the bright side and used her talent and her sense of humor to go from her little church choir to singing with Jim Reeves and Kenny Rogers. I'll always remember what fun it was growing up around our house.
Friends were always dropping in to sing and to try out new material and to write. Roger Miller was there, and Willie Nelson and Marty Robbins, to name a few. And Mom would cook up food for everybody, and they'd sing and talk for hours. Those times are my first memories of Ralph. He was always there with the guys, and in fact, he was such a regular at our house that he says he even changed my diapers once. I really can't remember a time that Ralph hasn't been there, encouraging and supporting me and my career. Ralph is like family, and he makes everyone else feel that way too. I think that's what country is all about. And Ralph, you're a big reason for that.
Today I started loving you again. I'm right back where I've really always been.
I'm Marty Haggard, and Merle's my dad. Merle Haggard is called a giant in country music, and he says that only in America could a man do what he did, and that's go from the bottom to the top, from being in San Quentin to playing at the White House lawn. But he's more than just a dad. He's the biggest single influence in my life. He's not only my hero, but he's my friend. He told me of the time he came to Nashville early on in his career, and he was supposed to do an interview with Ralph at about 2 o'clock, roughly. Well, Dad missed his wake-up call, and so when Ralph rang the room, he wasn't ready. They got into an argument that almost ended up in a knockdown, drag-out fight. Well, they mended up some fences real fast. That developed a real deep and strong friendship. Dad was there for Ralph many times after that. And some years later, Ralph was there for my dad when he really needed him. Dad never hid the fact that he loved his mother very deeply. And when she died, it was only one of the times that I've ever seen him devastated to the point being knocked to his knees. He only asked one person to speak at her funeral, and that was Ralph Emery. Over the years, Ralph has been an encouragement to me in my career too. Dad, I wish I could find the right words of thanks for all the advice and for all the example you've set for me. You've brought into my life so many wonderful friends, and Ralph, you definitely are a special friend.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
And he kisses wrapped in paper mean more to you than any of mine.
When I hear people say that George Morgan was the smoothest singer in country music, it makes me so very proud. I'm his youngest daughter, Lori Morgan. Even with such great successes like Candy Kisses, Dad was no stranger to hard times, but that never stood in his way. He tried to teach everyone how important it was in life to have a sense of humor. And believe me, there have been many times in my own life that I thank God for Dad and how he taught me that laughter truly is the best medicine. I remember the morning he took me with him to Ralph's early morning TV show. He sneaked up on Ralph and threw a pie in his face. And that's the way Dad was all the time. His friends at the Opry say they loved to be on the road with him. There were no private jets or tour buses, just singers and instruments crammed into a car. They say Dad kept them from getting bored and lifted their spirits. On Dad's 51st birthday, he introduced me on the Opry. I was only 16, and he was so proud that it made him cry. After my dad's death, Ralph took a real personal interest in me and used me regularly on his TV shows. Ralph, you've been the encouragement to me in my career that I know my father would have been if he was still here. I love you, Ralph.
Out in the West Texas town of El Paso, I fell in love with a Mexican girl. Nighttime would find me in Rose's Cantina. Music would play and Felina would whirl.
I was 8 years old, riding in the front seat of the family car when that song was born. I'm Ronnie Robbins. Marty was my dad. Mama was driving and Daddy was in the back seat with his guitar. And as we approached El Paso, the words started pouring out like a script from a movie. Daddy always had a deep love for the West and spent an awful lot of time there. I started working on the road with Daddy in 1968. Some of the advice he gave me was, kid, number one, don't ever stand in front of me on stage. And number two, don't ever forget the fans. Except for his family, the fans were always more important to him than anything. And it wasn't until Daddy died that I realized the huge impact he had on his fans and how deeply his music had affected people. That's also when I really felt the closeness and friendship of Ralph Emery the most. Ralph was Daddy's friend for about 30 years. When Ralph did the all-night show on WSM, Daddy'd call up many times, change his voice, and say something like, well, I'm out here on US 41, Ralph, and I sure would like to hear a Marty Robbins song tonight. It took Ralph quite a while to figure out what was going on. Ralph has always been there when our family needed him. And on the day of Daddy's funeral, he stood with us, and his presence really meant a lot to us during that time. He's one of those unique people that always thinks of others before he thinks of himself. Ralph, Daddy knew that, and that's why he loved you so much.
Is TNN, the Nashville Network.
And this will be Dolly Parton over here.
Is that Ralph Emery right
out here? I think so. I think it's him right out here.
But he don't know he's there.
No, he doesn't. This is a surprise.
Yeah, that's what I heard. Well, Ralph, we're here and you're there. And we wanted to talk about you, but Lord, there's so much to say. I don't know who should start. Won't you start?
Well, you know what we did? We finally weeded all the stuff we had to say and took the two good things we could think of and decided that we would do those at this point. Ralph, you know, the thing I remember most is when I was first starting in country music, coming up to the radio station and sitting there with you and that big cigar you used to smoke that used to make just choke me every time I would sit there. But I had to do that or you wouldn't play my records, but you were always nice enough to play them before everyone else did. And for that, I thank you. You're definitely a very big, important part of my career when I first started.
Well, you know, Ralph has been so good to me, or Ralph, you have, I'm telling you too. But you know, I don't know how many people can say this. I got married in 1966.
I went
to Ringgold, Georgia, and got married on a Monday and got back around 12 o'clock at night. Didn't have a honeymoon because I was booked on the Ralph Emery show and had to get up at 3 o'clock. So my new husband allowed me to go spend my honeymoon with Ralph Emery, but I got paid for that. I never got paid for this marriage.
Ralph, thanks for being such a good friend, not just to us, but to everybody in country music. You've truly been that, and we all appreciate that.
And we love you.
We do.
You know, folks, it's apparent that Ralph Emery is a man's man. My friend Jerry Reed, he knows what I'm talking about. Because when you're hot, you're hot.
Well, that's right, Ralph Emery. Listen, I've been at home sick with the flu. Why, I had me a fever of 102. Got out of my sick bed to come down here and do this show. You know why? Because me and you go back a long ways. Back to the good old days when you were first starting in radio. So now I got a question. The next time I do National Anthem, I want you to find some way, somehow, to let me do my story about me and Bubba at F-16. Right? Certainly it's gonna take about 25 minutes to do. But I got out of my sick bed for you. So what do you think? You gonna let me do my thing this time? Well, imagine that. Good. You know what? I think I'll go let Charlie Daniels take my temperature.
in the nights of honest loving the time can't take away. And I
This is me, Ralph. Lord, it's been a long, long time. No, this ain't no social call. And I bet this is about to blow your mind. You heard what? Well, it ain't true.
Country music. And thanks to my buddy Ralph Emery, everybody knows my name as
Whispering Bill Anderson. Ralph named me that, and I appreciate it. In just a minute, you're going to see the sweetest lady to ever grace this stage. Don't go away.
Sorry I can't be there with you tonight, but I hope you have a good time. And I'd just like to share with the audience the first time I ever met you. Well, I just moved to Nashville, and I was outside my apartment, and I was walking my dog. And you was visiting some friend that was living next to me in the apartments. And you came by, and you looked at my dog, and you said, "Oh, what a pretty cat." That's what our problem has always been, Ralph. You've never really been able to recognize me or my dog for what we really are. My dog's dead, but I still love you, and I really do appreciate you.
One of my best girlfriends is also one of Ralph's favorite ladies. He calls her the First Lady of the Grand Ole Opry and the First Lady of Comedy. The world loves her, but I promise you, no one loves this extraordinary lady more than me.
Ralph asked me if a girl minded kissing a fella with a beard, and I said, "Don't nobody mind going through a little brush to get to a picnic."
Cause of Minnie Pearl.
Happy! I'm just so proud to be here. Ralph, you didn't know nothing. Bless you. And you too, you little rat tail. I wanted to share with you that my brother has got a job. He called himself being a carpenter today. And you know what happened? He was working with Lucifer Hucklehead. Y'all don't know Lucifer Hucklehead. You ought to know him. He's wonderful. He's got a heart of gold and teeth to match. They was working on... Oh, I wish I hadn't raised my arm. I'm going to a costume party where everybody dresses as a flower. I'm going as a dried arrangement. He's got a job, and him and Lucifer Hucklehead was working on this building and working, building it, and brother dropped a saw and cut Luke's ear off, and it just scared them all to death. And brother said, "Don't worry, I'll get a doctor, we'll put that ear back on if I can find it." And he's down there in the sawdust trying to find an ear, and he found an ear. He said, "Luke, look, it's your ear." Luke said, "No, that ain't my ear. My ear had a pencil behind it." Well, you know, I've always loved fellers. I don't like Ralph Emery. I love him. I've loved him for a long time. I love you. And just think what beautiful music we could make together. What are we going to do about Joy and Henry? Thank you.
Well, here's a lady I've been wanting to introduce all night long. One of my favorite human beings, a great lady and a great talent, Miss Barbara Mandrell.
Get to do.
just go till I'm near to you.
Tell you a little story about it. Pulled in to get some coffee and I was driving the bus. When a big tour bus pulls into a truck stop or a restaurant, everybody looks out the window to see who's getting off the bus. I was the only one got off, walked in to get a cup of coffee, and they didn't recognize who I was. The girl came over and said, "What do you have?" I said, "A cup of coffee, please." And she leaned over kind of close to me and said, "Who have you got on that bus?" I thought a second and I said, "Well, we have Barbara Mandrell, Dolly Parton, Kenny Rogers, and Ralph Emery." She said, "Who is Ralph Emery?"
You know, we shared a lot of love with all you folks here tonight, and I hope you felt it too. You've joined with us in something that's been very personal and very wonderful, and we've just had some fun. We really have. But you know, I think our true feelings have just kind of come through.
I hope that you realize that the same kind of love goes on every day of the year. The real spirit, heart and soul of country music is love. Ladies and gentlemen, Eddie Arnold.
Have I told you that I love you? Could I tell you once again?
Thank you.
bless your heart, you haven't had a chance to talk all evening. Would you like to say something to all your friends tonight?
I would, Barbara. Thank you very much. I have never in my life experienced a night like this. This was a total secret. To say I'm stunned is to understate the issue. I have never felt as much love in my life. I only hope I can convey as much love that has been coming my way back to all of the wonderful people in what we call the business. The business of country music has been very good to all of us, especially good to me, because it brought me all of these nice people, brought them into my life, made them my friends, and I appreciate that. I owe a special debt to my good friend Barbara Mandrell, because I know she was the ramrod of this show. I thank all of you for coming. God bless you.
Thank you all for joining us this evening. We want you to always be as happy as you've made us tonight. And as Ralph Emery always says, Mr. Whitehurst, let's go home.